The next experiment what we are going to see is generation of Gaussian noise and its spectrum, and next one is generation of AM with additive Gaussian white noise. Okay, so these are the two experiments next we are going to see. So before going into the experiments, we must know what is noise, what are the types of noise, what is white noise, what is additive Gaussian white noise. Okay, so first we are going to study the noise in communication system. So noise, the unwanted signal with the modulated signal is called noise. The unwanted signal that is coming with the modulated signal is called noise. The noise is an unwanted signal. Okay, noise is a unwanted signal which is coming with the modulated signal. Noise is random in nature. Okay, noise is random in nature. Noise degrade the level of quality of the received signal at the receiver. So noise will degrade the level of quality of the received signal at the receiver. Due to the presence of noise, efficiency of the communication system reduces. Okay, due to the presence of noise, the efficiency of the communication system get reduces. So noise has infinite energy. Okay, this noise is having infinite energy. Now we are going for the types of noise. Types of noise, there are two types, that is, one is internal noise, another one is external noise. The internal noise is white noise, white noise, Gaussian noise and Johnson noise. These are the internal noise. External noise is noise, solar noise, crosstalk and lightning. Noise occurred due to crosstalk, lightning and solar, they are called external noise. And the internal noise are white noise, Gaussian noise and Johnson noise. Now we are going to study what is thermal noise. Due to the thermal agitation, charge carriers, that is the electrons in the electrical conductor, gain energy and they move in random fashion. This movement of electron generates heat and this heat corresponds to thermal noise. Due to the movement of electrons, current flows in the conductor and this current creates noise voltage N of t. Okay, due to the movement of this electrons, current flows in the conductor and this current creates a noise voltage N of t. This noise voltage is influenced by the temperature, therefore it is called thermal noise. Okay, this noise is influenced by temperature, so it is called thermal noise. This thermal noise is also called as Johnson noise or white noise. Okay, this thermal noise is also called as Johnson noise and white noise. So the thermal noise is a power signal. Okay, the thermal noise is also referred as white noise because it has uniform spectral density. Since it is having uniform spectral density, it is called white noise. The thermal noise is called as white noise because it is having an uniform spectral density. This point is important. Okay, now this is a spectrum of your white noise and here it is having uniform, here it is having uniform spectral density, uniform spectral density. So in 1928, J.B. Johnson have proven that noise power generated is proportional to the temperature and bandwidth. Okay, the noise power is proportional to temperature and bandwidth. When changing the proportionality sign, we will be getting a constant K, where P is a noise power, K is a Boltzmann constant. Its value is 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 3 joules per Kelvin. T is a temperature and B is a bandwidth spectrum in Hertz. How to determine the noise level in communication system? So noise effect can be determined by measuring the signal to noise ratio for an analog system. So in an analog system, the noise can be determined by measuring the signal to noise ratio for an analog system. For digital system, the probability of error or bit error rate, The noise effect is determined from bit error rate. Okay. So to determine the quality of the received signal at the receiver, that is at antenna, signal to noise ratio of the input and the signal to noise ratio of the receiver are used. Okay. So in order to determine the quality of a received signal, we will be measuring the signal to noise ratio in the output as well as signal to noise ratio in the input. So signal to noise ratio in the output is always less than signal to noise ratio in the input because of the existence of noise in the receiver itself. Okay. So always the signal to noise ratio of the output will be less than that of input. Okay. So the signal to noise ratio of the output is less than input due to the presence of noise in the receiver itself. Now, how to calculate the noise? So signal to noise ratio is a ratio of signal power to noise power. What is signal to noise ratio? It is a ratio of signal power to noise power. Okay. It is a ratio of signal power to noise power. So signal to noise ratio is represented in dB as 10 log S by N. S is signal and N is noise. Noise figure is nothing but it is a ratio of signal to noise ratio of input divided by output. What is noise figure? Noise figure is a signal to noise ratio of input divided by output and is represented in decibel. Noise factor is nothing but 10 log of noise figure. What is noise factor? Noise factor is nothing but 10 log of noise figure. So if F, that is noise figure, equal to 1 for noiseless networks, in general the value of F will be greater than 1. The noise figure value will be greater than 1. Okay. Lower the value of noise figure, the better the network or system. Okay. If the value of the F is low, if the value of F is low, then the system or network will be a better one. Now we are going to study Gaussian distribution. So we are going to study Gaussian or normal distribution. So the normal or Gaussian distribution is an important family of continuous probability distribution. So this Gaussian distribution is an important family of continuous probability distribution. The standard normal distribution is a normal distribution with the zero mean and unity variance. What is standard normal distribution? Standard normal distribution is a normal distribution with the zero mean. If your mean is zero and if you are having unity variance, then it is called standard normal distribution. So for a Gaussian distribution, the mean and average are the defining parameters. What are the defining parameters in Gaussian distribution? The mean and variance. Mean and variance are the defining parameters of the normal distribution. So many measurements from psychological to thermal noise can be approximated by Gaussian distribution. So by using Gaussian distribution, we can approximate the psychological measurements, that is the brain measurements, as well as the thermal noise. Thermal noise is also approximated by using Gaussian distribution. Now, this is a Gaussian distribution. This is the shape of the Gaussian distribution. This is bell shaped. Okay. So the expression is f of x is equal to 1 by root of 2 pi sigma square into e to the power minus x minus mu the whole square divided by 2 sigma square. Mu is a mean. Sigma is a variance. Okay. Now we are going to study what is additive white Gaussian noise. So this noise is called additive because it is added to any noise that might be intrinsic to the information system. Okay, so why it is called additive means it is added to, it can be added to any noise that might be intrinsic to the information system. Why it is called white means it is having uniform power spectral density, or it is having uniform power across the frequency band. Okay, so it is an analogy to the color white. So the white color is having uniform emission at all frequencies in the visible spectrum, so it is called white. So why we are calling it as white noise means its power spectral density is uniform for all frequency. Similarly, the white light, it will give uniform emissions for all frequencies in visible spectrum. It will be giving uniform emission for all frequencies, so it is called white. Now Gaussian is a normal distribution with an average time domain value of 0. Okay, what is Gaussian? Gaussian is, already we have studied, Gaussian is a normal distribution with an average time domain value of 0. The random process x of t, you are having only one x of t. The random process x of t is called a white noise process if x of t is a stationary Gaussian random process with a zero mean and a flat power spectral density. So if a random process is having zero mean and flat power spectral density, then it is called a white noise. Okay, white Gaussian noise. So the power spectral density S of X of is equal to N naught by 2. This is a power spectral density of white noise. So this is a expression already we have studied. P of x is equal to 1 divided by root of 2 pi sigma into e to the power minus x minus mu the whole square by 2 into sigma square. The value of x varies from minus infinity to infinity. A Gaussian distribution is completely specified by two values. That is its mean and variance. Mu is a mean and sigma is a variance. So a Gaussian distribution is completely specified by two values. One is its mean and next one is its variance. So this is the one reason it is popular and a useful model. Since it is specified only by two values, it is so popular and a useful model. So next, additive white Gaussian noise. So the noise is usually additive in nature. This additive white Gaussian noise is, this noise is additive in nature. We can add with this signal. Okay, you are having this signal and this noise will be added with this signal. So why it is called white means it is having uniform spectral density. It is having uniform spectral density. So Gaussian means the noise voltage amplitude have Gaussian distribution or normal distribution. So here in additive Gaussian white noise, the noise voltage will be having a Gaussian distribution. Okay. Next one is narrow band noise. When a additive white Gaussian noise signal is passed through a band pass filter, when you are passing a additive white Gaussian noise to a band pass filter, the resulting thing is called narrow band noise. Okay, what is narrow band noise? When you pass additive white Gaussian noise to a band pass filter, we'll getting the narrow band noise. To find the effect of the noise signal on AM and double sideband suppressed carrier and single sideband suppressed carrier, the noise should be considered as either an additive white Gaussian noise or a narrow band noise. This narrow band noise can be expressed as the sum of two components. One is in phase component and another one is quadrature component. Two component you are having. One is NC of T is a in phase component. Q of NQ is the quadrature component, that is NC of T into cos 2 pi fc of T plus NQ of T into sin 2 pi fc of T. This is a representation of additive white Gaussian noise. So this NC of T is a low pass signal and it is an in phase component, and NQ of T is a low pass signal and a quadrature component. So this is a combination of some of this in phase component and quadrature component. So this is a power spectral density of additive white Gaussian noise affecting AM and double sided suppressed AM, okay, DSB. So this is a spectrum, okay, noise spectrum of this additive white Gaussian noise. So noise power is equal to 2B into N naught by 2 into 2. So you'll be getting noise power is equal to 2 N naught B. So we have studied the basics of noise. What is white noise? Why it is called white noise? What is additive Gaussian white noise? Its distribution. And we have studied what is narrow band noise, its representation. And we have studied the power spectral density of additive white Gaussian noise. Okay. Now we are going to see the program of Gaussian noise and its power spectrum. So aim of this experiment to write the MATLAB program for generation of Gaussian noise and plot its power spectrum. The equipment required is PC with Windows operating system, MATLAB software. The procedure is you have to switch on the power, then you have to open the MATLAB software by clicking the MATLAB icon on the desktop. Then you have to open the editor window and you have to write the program in it. Then you have to save the program in the workspace. Then you have to run the program and we have to draw the graph. We have to view the graph. Now we have to see the program for Gaussian distribution. Okay. We are going for Gaussian distribution. So first, CLC, that is clear command window, clear all will clear all the variables in the workspace, close all the figure windows already present. Then first we are going to generate, so this is also coming with this command line. Okay, so this is also in green in color. So next we are going to generate the random numbers. Okay, we are generate 20 random numbers. For that we are using the function random n 1,2000. So this function or this line, what it will do means it will generate 20 random numbers. Okay, next to what you are going to do is you are going to plot the joint distribution of both the set using dot. So please listen. So first we are using subplot 2, 1, 1. So here we are going to draw the random numbers, then we are going to draw the distribution. So first by using subplot you are going to plot this random numbers, that is subplot of 2, 1, 1. The meaning is it is having two rows. This is the first row, one column, and the first figure. Plot x comma within the quotes you are putting dot. Now what it will do means it will plot the x and it will plot as dots. Okay, so that is plot x comma dot. The title what you are giving to this plot is scatter plot of Gaussian distributed random numbers. Okay, then you are going to, in order to plot the Gaussian distribution, you need the value of mean and variance. So y mu is equal to mean of x. This is your x. So we have generated the random numbers. No. So first you are calculating the mean of that x. Then sigma, y sigma is equal to standard deviation of x. So std of x will find the standard deviation. Mu will calculate the mean. Then you are going to find the distribution. P is equal to normal probability density function. Norm PDF is nothing but normal probability distribution density function. X comma, you are giving the values of mean and variance, y mu, y sigma. These two values you are giving because your Gaussian distribution needs the value of mu and sigma. Both the values we have given. Then subplot 2, 1, 2. So this is a second diagram. Okay. In this figure, you are having two diagrams. First one is the random numbers and next one is the distribution. This is 2, 1, 1. This is 2, 1, 2. So here you are using plot. So in order to plot the discrete values, you will be using the command stem. For continuous, you'll be using plot. Okay, so we are using stem x comma p. X is a random variable, p is nothing but your this function. Okay, Gaussian distribution. Title is Gaussian distribution. Okay, so you have completed the program and this is your output. We are getting two output. This is subplot 2 1 1. This is subplot 2 1 2. Here you are getting the 2000 random variables. Like dots, it is plotted. 2000 random variables. We have Gaussian distributed random numbers. Okay, 2000 numbers you are having. Next one, this is a Gaussian distribution. So we have plotted the Gaussian distribution as well as scatter plot of Gaussian distributed random numbers. Okay. Next, we are going to write the MATLAB program for the generation of AM signal with Gaussian noise. What is the next program? So next program is to write a MATLAB program for generation of AM signals with Gaussian noise. The equipment required is PC with Windows and MATLAB software. So procedure is, first you have to switch on the power, then you have to open the MATLAB by clicking the MATLAB icon in the desktop. Then you have to open the editor window and you have to write the program in it. Then you have to save the program in the workspace. Then you have to run the program and you have to view the graph. Next, we are going to see the program. Okay, now first we are going to clear the command window. Then we are going to clear the workspace. Then we are closing all figure windows. Then we are defining the frequency of the message signal, frequency of the carrier. Then we are defining the amplitude of the message signal and the amplitude of carrier. Then we are defining the modulation index and we are taking it as 0.8. Then we are defining the x-axis. Okay, so for x-axis, for in this program, there is no need of this frequency. Okay, so no need to define this frequency because we are only drawing in the time axis. Okay, we are defining the time axis, that is 0 to 0.999. the increment is 0.0001. then what we are going to do is we are defining the upper envelope, lower envelope, and we are going to define the upper envelope and lower envelope of your modulated signal. Okay, modulated signal of AM. This is your upper envelope, this is your lower envelope. Okay, now next we are going to define the modulating signal or message signal. We are defining the modulating signal. So VM, actually this capital VM is a modulating signal and small VM is a amplitude of your message signal, and capital VC is a carrier signal and VC is a amplitude of your carrier signal. So FM is a frequency of your modulating signal and FC is a frequency of your carrier signal. Now this VAM, so here you are going to generate the AM signal. What you are doing here, VAM is nothing but you are generating the amplitude modulated signal. Okay, we are generating the amplitude modulated signal. Next, what we are going to do is we are adding additive white Gaussian noise to this amplitude modulated signal. So we are taking Y as a AM with additive white Gaussian noise. AM with additive white Gaussian noise. So this function AWGN, it will add additive white Gaussian noise with this AM. VAM is a amplitude modulated signal. This 10 is nothing but the signal to noise ratio. Signal to noise ratio. The meaning of this measured is, before adding this noise, it will measure the power of your signal. The meaning of this measured is, before adding noise, it will, this function will measure the power of your signal. Okay, power of your modulated signal. So this AWGN is a function which will add additive white Gaussian noise with your modulated signal. And this 10 indicates signal to noise ratio. Measured means it will find the signal power before adding noise. Now, next you are going to plot the modulating signal and carrier. So here how you are plotting means, first you are using two figures. In the first figure, you are plotting the modulating signal and carrier. So this is the first figure. So in the first figure, you are drawing two figures. This is a modulating signal, this is a carrier signal. So this is subplot 211 and this is subplot 212. Okay, this is 211, 212, and you are drawing the time axis versus VM is a what? Modulating signal. And we are giving the title as what? AM modulating signal. Title of AM modulating signal. X label, in the X label you are giving time, Y label you are giving amplitude, and you are making grid on. So grid on means in the output you will be getting some boxes, grids. Then in the second subplot 212, you are plotting the carrier. Plot T, VC. In the title you are giving AC carrier signal. Then in the X label you are giving time, in the Y label you have giving amplitude, grid on. Next, you are going to plot AM in time domain. Okay, so we are going to plot AM in time domain and AM with additive white Gaussian noise in time domain. So we are drawing it in the second figure. Okay, we are drawing it in the second figure. So the second figure you are drawing. So this, so you are defining the subplot 212. First you are giving figure 2. Figure 2, it will generate a new figure. And in the first 211, this is 211 and this is 212. In the first subplot, we are plotting the amplitude modulated signal. T, VAM. VAM is a amplitude modulated signal. And you are holding, hold on will in the same, you can use this hold on if you want to draw some other things in the same figure. Okay, so you are drawing the upper envelope and lower envelope, that is plot T, V1 is a upper envelope, T, V2 is a upper lower envelope. This R is nothing but it will coming in red color. Okay, now title you are giving it as AM waveform in time domain. Then X label time, Y label amplitude, grid on. Then in the second subplot, that is 212, you are going to draw the AM with additive white Gaussian noise. So you have calculated Y. Y is nothing but AM with additive white Gaussian noise. Plot T, Y. You will be getting the what? You will be getting the additive AM with additive white Gaussian noise. In the X label, you are giving it as time. In the Y label, you are giving it as amplitude. And in the title, you are giving it as amplitude modulated signal with additive white Gaussian noise. Now this is your output. So the first figure, this is figure 1. In figure 1 you are having two outputs. One is the modulating signal and another one is a carrier signal. Now in the second figure you are having AM waveform in time domain, and second one is amplitude modulated signal with additive white Gaussian noise. So you have added noise with this modulated signal and we are getting the output here. Okay, we are getting additive white Gaussian noise. Completed all the three programs in the software part. Okay, so now we will study how to execute the thing in MATLAB.
Students, next we are going to type the program for Gaussian distribution. Okay, so first you have to click the MATLAB icon. So MATLAB will be opened. After opening the MATLAB, you have to click new script. So you'll be getting your editor window. Okay, you'll be getting your editor window. So you've got the editor window. So you have to type the program. So you have to type the program for Gaussian distribution. Okay, we are going to plot the Gaussian distributor numbers and its spectrum. So after that you have to save. You have to save the program in the folder what we have created. Okay, this is program 5. Program 5. So I have saved. After saving, once it is saved, the subtitle will change. Okay, so now the program is saved. Now I am executing by clicking run. This is going to execute this program. So it will take some time and you will be getting the result. Okay, you will get the result. Students, we got the output. So this is the output. Okay, so you are getting the output. So this is a scattered plot of Gaussian distributed random numbers, and this is a spectrum of distribution. Okay, this is a spectrum of Gaussian distribution and this is a scatter plot of Gaussian distributed random numbers. So we got the output. Okay, this is the output. This is a scatter plot of Gaussian distributed random numbers and this is a Gaussian distribution. Okay, next we are going to see the amplitude modulated wave with additive white Gaussian noise. So first we, after making your PC on, you have to click MATLAB. So MATLAB will get opened. After that you have to open the editor window. So in order to edit, open the editor window, you have to click new script. So when you are clicking new script, the editor window will be opened. Okay, when you are clicking your new script, the editor window will be opened. So now we are going to type the program. Okay, now we have typed the program. So I have typed the program, then I have to save. I have to save the program what I have typed. So I am going to save this program in the folder what I have created. I am giving the program, name as program 6. Okay. I have saved the program. So the program is saved. Now I am going to execute this program. So students, we got the output. So you're having two figures. In the first figure, you are having the modulating signal and the carrier signal. You're having modulating signal and the carrier signal in the first figure. And in the second figure, you're having, we're enlarging the figure. In the second figure, you're having this modulated signal. This is a modulated, this is the upper envelope, this is a lower envelope. So this is the carrier, the amplitude of this carrier wave is varied in accordance to the message signal. This is a message signal, okay. So it is varied. Now this is a amplitude modulated signal with additive white Gaussian noise. Okay, the second diagram is nothing but amplitude modulated signal with additive white Gaussian noise. So we have typed the program, we have saved and executed. So you know how to run the programs in MATLAB. Okay, students.